How does it feel to be a UFC fighter?
This is my dream. So if your dream comes true, so it's like I can't explain. When I hearing Puja, now you have my manager called me, Puja, now you are in UFC. I'm saying, sure? He said, yeah. At that time, I'm like crying. I'm just thinking where I call. I called my mama, everyone. Now I'm in UFC. So that moment, so like I feel so proud.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to a brand new episode of Smack Talk with Sandhu. So on my last episode, I spoke to Anshul Jubli, and at the time that I spoke to him, he was the only Indian fighter signed to the UFC. The episode drops, and the day it drops, breaking news, the UFC signed another Indian fighter, but some history was made. My guest this week is the very first Indian female fighter signed in promotional history by the UFC. My guest this week is Puja Tomar. Puja, first of all, thank you very much for coming on the show, and congratulations. How does it feel?
Thank you so much.
How does it feel to be a UFC fighter?
This is my dream. So if your dream comes true, so it's like I can't explain. When I hearing Puja, now you have my manager called me, Puja, now you are in UFC. I'm saying, sure? He said, yeah. At that time, I'm like crying. I'm just thinking where I call. I called my mama, everyone. Now I'm in UFC. So that moment, so like I feel so proud.
Where were you when you found out that you were in the UFC, and what was your immediate reaction?
When I get UFC contract, after 4 days, my coach saying, okay, after 2-3 days, we are going to post. But this 3-4 days, but I want to say everybody, now I have a UFC contract, but okay, we can take a little bit break. But after that, we post, we are now, I'm in UFC, so the media, everyone just message, call my phone, like 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. That's like, I don't have idea this thing is happened, but it's...
What was the impact? What was the impact of the news in India from the media and the fans? Like, did you start to feel the love of everyone being excited that you have been signed by the UFC?
Yeah, everybody's so excited because of female also. In India, it's female represent India like this platform. So it's a very big thing for India. So everybody... so excited, so happy, and say we have very hope for you. So all the best, like this message.
So Puja, what is the beginning of your mixed martial arts journey? How did you get into MMA?
Yeah, when I was like 6 years old, my father passed away. So we don't have any brother, and my father also passed away. So we don't have any man in our house, just 2 sisters and my mother. So we have like big family, my father, brother, and every time they pinch my mom, you have to go for marriage your daughter. But outside people also like, oh, you guys don't have father, so sorry. Every time some female come in our house and they say with my mom, oh, you don't have man and you don't have any boy, what you do next. So every time I'm hearing, so like inside it's coming aggression. That time, why people like only man? No, I don't want to become a man, but I want to, I want to fix in this, how I don't know how I say like that. So I want to become your boy, mama. Don't take stress. So I start to learn. I watched the Jackie Chan movie. So I start to learn how I protect my sister with some from someone. So then I start little bit karate, kung fu. After that, I was going for karate championship. But karate, you know, it's like only touching game. So I hit one girl hardly. They disqualify me. I say, why? I was win. The girl on the ground, I was win. So no, Puja, if you're going too hard, this game not for you. Go another, choose another game. My journey so long. Because very things is happen in English to explain is hard for me. So I want to explain little things.
Yeah.
So I do hard work. My farmer.
Yeah. On the farm. Yep.
Yeah. I work hard on my farm because we need money for study my sister. Then somebody told me, Puja, if you're going to for this fight, they give you money for MMA. Before in India, I have one organization who organize MMA. So my one friend say, Puja, if you're going to this event, they give you money. I think, okay, I'm going to fight in this event. Maybe my sister needs to money for study. Then I participate and I win one fight. Then they give me money. I sent for my sister because she was study for doctor. I don't want to my sister leave her study, so I want to pay because we don't have any business, anything for money. So that time I'm thinking, no, I need money for my sister. I don't want to stress my mom, for my mom. I have to work. Before I fight MMA for money.
Yeah,
it's my passion, my dream, everything.
So Puja, you're working on a farm, you're watching Jackie Chan movies, you're fighting in India to help your sister with her education so she can become a doctor. But during this time, were you a fan of the UFC? Were you watching the UFC? And at that time, was your dream, oh, I can now maybe fight in the UFC one day? Like, what was your thinking early in your career?
That time, I also fight in Wushu Shanda, amateur fight. And I was also like 4-5 time national champion. And that time, my dream become a Olympic gold medalist, but Wushu not in Olympic. So, but that time, our situation very bad. We don't have money for going to good training, nothing. But in Wushu, if you win gold medal, so Indian government give you money. But 1 year just for one gold medal is not enough for our family. So that time I decide I have to move for another things. I have to go somewhere how I make money for my family. So my one friend suggests me, if you're going to like this type of fight, they give you money. So that time I decide, okay, I go for money. Just then I fight, I was win, and then I send my sister. That time I'm not thinking about the UFC. I don't have any idea. That time just I'm thinking I have to go and I fight to in cage, just like road fight. Okay, it's easy for me because my heart and my mind always ready for this thing. My whole life, many bad things I'm hearing. So it's, you know, if you're hearing many bad things, your heart is like become more stronger. If you wanna go, if somebody kill me, no problem. I'm gonna go and kill someone. So that time I was win and they give me money. Then I send my sister. After that, I'm thinking, oh, this maybe no. I have to go back Wushu for my maybe if I've been Asian game medalist, so maybe more. I choose sports, but I choose for money, because we need money also. So I don't have any idea my journey bring me here.
It's amazing. It's an incredible journey. And it's quite the accomplishment for you to make it to the UFC. But on the road to the UFC, you know, you fought for one championship and you also fought for Matrix Fight Night in India. So what were those two experiences like for you as you kind of built up more experience and you started to get more professional fights?
I was fighting one championship also, but that time also I fight for money, because of I don't have money for training, nothing. When I was fighting SFL, Indian promotion, so I don't have any idea with the, I don't know also this is the Asia big promotion. Somebody messaged me and you wanna go to one? I said, what is this one? One championship is like Asia's number one league and this is very good platform. So, okay, let's go. I want. They give good money. He say, yes, let's go. So, because I don't have any platform, I didn't have any platform for training. So, okay, if they give good money, it's I need for my sister, my family, let's go. Then I go, I didn't have any experience. And I lost my fight. But after that, when I fight, I switch in MFN. And MFN owner, Aisha Shroff, she helped me. Her heart so good. She can understand the fighter. She's not like treat, okay, you are fighter and you come for money. No. Every time she's thinking, no, he have a fighter, he needs this thing. So she sent us like me and two more fighter had for belt fighter. So she sent us Bali, go for training. If you want to become champion, I think you need the training. She sent us, and then I totally changed. I go to Bali, then I train in Soma Fight Club. My coach, Mike, he watched my fight, last fight. Then he decided, no, Puja, you are not going to like this. You have to change. I say, yes, coach. Then he work on me, and he understands, yeah, you're hardworking girl. Let's do it. Then I did my hard work. Then I get my belt.
Yeah, it's incredible, because I was speaking to Anshul about this too. So Soma Fight Club in Bali, it seems to be growing very, very quickly with a lot of fighters coming there. And it's a professional setup where you can obviously train and get experience and get better as a fighter. And obviously you're signed now by the UFC, but you're signed coming off a 4-fight winning streak. You're coming into the UFC as the MFN strawweight champion. So this must give you lots of motivation, and you're coming, you know, on the up to the UFC, right?
Yeah, loads of motivation. This time now I have experience and I have like confidence, and now I have coach also. My coach and Soma, like my family, my home. That time, when I was in one and SFN, no coach, no training center, nothing. But I have now everything, so I will do it.
When do you think you will get your first fight in the UFC? When are you hoping to fight for the promotion?
Maybe in Feb and March.
February, March, okay. Yep. And what do you think of the strawweight division? Obviously, Zhang Weili is the champion, but there's Tatiana Suarez and Zhan Zhaonan and Carla Esparza and Mackenzie Dern and Jessica Andrade. What are your thoughts on the strawweight division in the UFC, and how do you compare to everybody else?
Yes. In UFC, strawweight have many girls who's good strength and a very good fighter. So when I was fighting MFN also, I asked to Aisha ma'am, can I fight in atom weight, because my running weight like 50 kg sometime. So I was, can I fight? I was asking Aisha ma'am, I want to fight atom weight, can I? So they okay, they decide, okay Puja, you can fight in straw atom weight. But after like two fight, I was fighting straw weight, then they decide to become a champion, MFN champion. Puja, no, you have to change your weight category, you have to fight in straw weight. So I eat every time, I gain my weight. But for UFC, now I'm thinking I want to change many things with me. I have to a little bit more gain my weight. I have to improve my strength. I need more improve myself for the UFC because every girl's like the beast. So I am also beast, but I wanna become a champion.
No, for sure. Absolutely. And that should be the goal. If you enter the UFC, you should want to compete with the best, fight the best, and ultimately try and become a champion there. With regards to Anshul, obviously, I had him on my show last week. He had a massive fight at UFC 294 in Abu Dhabi. He did so well in those first two rounds, and obviously things didn't, you know, work out in the third round. The one thing I noticed, though, is the amount of support Anshul got both before the fight and after the fight. It blew my mind. It was incredible. Have you also noticed this, the support from Indian fans and Indian people on social media? Are you starting to feel the love from people as they get ready to see you fight in the UFC for the first time?
Yeah. Now Anshul, he's a celebrity in India. Everybody like so excited for his fight, and before he was fighting Road to UFC, so everybody thinking, no, Anshul become a champion also, and he's a champion. I don't know what happened with him. He knows, because I know how he trained. He trained so hard. He was injured, but he trained so hard. He's every time he like walking like this, because I think his ankle, we know. But his fan know why. I hearing also the bad comments after his fight, but they don't know. They just know win and lose. He did well. He did two round very good. After that, I don't know what happened with him. But he's a very good fighter, and maybe next fight he's going to win.
Yeah, absolutely. As we kind of wrap up here, what is your message to MMA fans, UFC fans, the people of India? What can they expect from Puja Tomar when you do fight in the UFC in February, March in 2024? What are you going to bring to the table?
Now I can see many fans in India. Before, when I was fighting one and another promotion, like I start MMA, nobody don't know MMA. But now I can see all messages every day. Every fans and everybody messages me, no Puja, you have to become a champion. And now MMA is like very fast growing in India, and I want to say everybody, please support me, and please, in India, cricket so famous. So we.
You're doing great. This is fantastic. But I know what you're trying to say. This is so much fun to talk to you. And like I said earlier on, and I'll say it again, we were supposed to have a translator to help, you know, with this interview. But Puja, you've done a great job. You know, I know you were, you know, very kind of nervous to do this interview in English because it isn't your first language, but I appreciate it greatly. I thought you did fantastic. I am very excited to see you fight in the UFC in 2024. And I'll say the same thing to Anshul that I'll say to you and any other Indian fighter. You have my support. Anything I can do to help, please let me know and to get the word out there. But yeah, I'm very much looking forward to it, and best of luck. as you kind of put your camp together and you start to train and prepare. And I'm very much looking forward to seeing who your first opponent will be in the UFC as well.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for listening to this episode of Smack Talk with Sandhu. It really means a lot to me. And hey, listen, if you enjoyed this episode, please go and give it a follow on Spotify and Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your shows.